Most of you guys might not even realize that there's a way in YouTube analytics that you can do some A-B testing and comparing how one series of content might be performing against another series of content, so you can make a better decision what series to invest into, what's worth your time, what's not worth your time, rather than just making a lot of videos and just trying to do some guesswork. Let me take you to my desktop here and show you exactly how you can do this in your analytics. Hey guys, my name is Tim Schmoyer and welcome to Video Creators. This channel is all about helping you guys grow your YouTube audience so you can spread a message that reaches people and changes their life. And if you want to reach people, you need to make content that goes out and gets them. Now, one thing that I've been trying to do here on this channel is experiment with a lot of different formats, from doing blog, doing podcast interviews and doing like motion graphics and doing blog style things, just to compare like what do you guys respond to, what doesn't, what's getting me more watch time, subscribers, things like that. And so what you can do in your YouTube analytics, they actually have a feature that most creators don't even use. It's called groups, and you'll find it right here in the upper right corner. And you can either create a video group or a playlist group. Now, I recommend, just for our purposes here, starting off and making a video group. And what you do is you can search for different videos on your channel, give the group a name. So let's just say, for example, this is going to be I've already made these groups, so I'm just making this up right now, but like podcast videos, okay? And then I go through here, search for them, find all of the podcast videos, or you can add them by ID if that's easier. You just copy and paste them in here, your video IDs, and you just check the ones. I'm just checking random ones over here, and then you save and create that group. Now, I've already created a few groups. You can create groups from playlists and things as well, but I'm going to go browse all groups. Like this. Now, so what I can do, I have how-to interviews, consultation recordings, tutorials, live Q&As, live news streams, podcast vlogs. You can see how many videos I have in each of them right now. And I can add these. I can look at these side by side. So here I'm going to look at how-to interviews. Now I'm looking at the real-time analytics for these right now. Go to comparison. Maybe I'm going to change this second one to how-to tutorials. I don't know, how-to interviews versus tutorials. So rather than live real-time, let's come down here. Let's look at like watch time, for example, and see how these two groups are comparing. Okay, so I can see, whoa, okay, how-to tutorials far outperforming the interview. So that might be a good indication to me that, Tim, if you're going to teach someone how to do something on this channel, do it as a tutorial, not as an interview. Now, I also need to look and see like what videos are in each of these groups, because it might be I have one really high-performing tutorial that's kind of throwing all the data off. So sometimes what I'll do is I'll make these groups is I'll take the 10% top and the 10% bottom off. So the top 10% that are performing the best, I won't include those videos, and the top 10 and the lowest 10% of videos that are performing the worst, I won't include those either. But then I'll make sure that there's similar date ranges and stuff. But over here, you can kind of just start seeing how valuable these groups get when you can start seeing how they compare in watch time and views and average view duration on each of the videos that are in each of these groups here, and really start comparing these things side by side. Now, I'm doing this as like a side by side comparison of videos based on the content, based on the style. But you could do it based on, let's say you have a branded intro that you want to evaluate, and you want to know, is this new branded intro going to increase subscriptions or decrease subscription watch time or decrease watch time? So maybe you have one branded intro A that you run for like 2 months, and then branded intro B that you run for 2 months and all your content, and then you have a group of branded intro 1, branded intro 2, just put them in your analytics and look at them side by side to kind of see how they're doing. You could evaluate style. You could evaluate content elements such as like call to actions or branded intros. You could do it based on your content goals, such as like discoverable content versus community content, if you want to measure like engagement or things like, or any of the combination of all of the above. Coming back to this example, you can see that one of the reasons why how to tutorials is so much bigger is that, look, I only have 4 videos in the how to interviews, the blue, and I have 25 videos in that group. So it's not quite an apples to apples comparison. Another thing that I might do with these is only include videos in these groups that I've published over the past 2 months or 3 months or 6 months, whatever date range you want to set, so that so I'm making the how-to interviews and tutorials side by side at the same time, posting maybe one of those, each of those a week, and then I'm only taking into consideration the videos that were published around the same time frame, so it's a better apples to apples comparison. So let's do look at like live stream Q&As versus like maybe live stream or news live streams. Okay, so how do those two live things compare to each other as far as performance is concerned? And I'm going to set the date range on these to like lifetime probably here, so I can get more data since I haven't updated the live streaming groups here recently. Here we go. Okay, so I can see that there are 7 videos in the news streams and only 4 in the Q&A. So I can look at these and kind of see already though that watch time minutes. I mean, the top one I got in the Q&A is is only 26,000 watch time minutes, and the live news ones are getting a lot more. So all of my live news streams outperform my live Q&As, which is good for me to know. So when I go live, doing live Q&A is probably just strictly a community play. It is not a discoverability play. Whereas when I live stream about news, that's a good, probably better discoverability play than the Q&As. There is a lot more you can do in here. Like you can edit groups, make copies of groups, delete groups and everything. But it's a really great tool to start doing some things intentionally and strategically on your channel and putting them side by side to see what's working, what's not working, what to eliminate, what to invest more into, and test a lot of your stuff rather than just throwing it against a wall and seeing what sticks. I want to hear from you guys in the comments about how you plan to use groups in your YouTube analytics and what data you hope to find from that. And the rest of you guys, if you want more ideas about this, read the comments down there below. You're going to learn a ton from the other people here at this community who are experimenting with this as well. Now, if this is your first time here at Video Creators, I would love to have you subscribe. We're just all about helping you guys grow your YouTube channels so you can spread a message that reaches people and changes their life. So thank you for letting me be a small part of that here today. Subscribe, and I'll see you guys again on Monday, hopefully, for a live stream. See you then. Bye.